Dear viewers, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows a case of inguinal hernia. You can see the inguinal canal, right? Inguinal canal, and the gut loops are protruding to this inguinal canal into the right scrotum. A hernia occurs when an organ or fatty tissue squeezed through a weak spot in the surrounding muscle or connective tissue called fascia. The most common types of hernia are inguinal, inner groin, incisional resulting from an incision, femoral, outer groin, umbilical, belly button, and hiatal upper stomach. An inguinal hernia occurs when tissue such as part of the intestine protrudes through the weak spot in the abdominal muscles. This results in a bulge which may be painful, especially when you cough, bent over, or lift a heavy object. Now this is the inguinal canal, and you can see as it approaches the scrotum, a significant amount of fluid collection is seen. This is the fluid collection. Ultrasound is a non-invasive, non-ionizing radiation modality which is highly successful at soft tissue imaging. Groin pain from an occult hernia can be a difficult clinical diagnosis, made easier by good imaging by optimizing the image using depth, focus, and gain of the ultrasound machine. You can see the testes. The patient is a male child, aged about 12 years. Now what you can expect from ultrasound, the findings. The ultrasound findings are a herniated gut loop along with some fluid collection at inguinal region. As you can see in this case, the fluid collection is visible. Then testes and epididymis pulled up with herniated contents. Then hydrocele on the respective involved size is also visible, as in this case, and the normal testes on the unaffected side. Again, you can see the herniated sac having some intestinal contents, and a fluid collection is seen at inguinal region. You will see by uncuffing the contents of the hernia, that is intestine, makes a vigorous movements. A bulge in the groin area is visible. Because standing and cuffing can make the hernia more prominent, you will like to be asked to stand up and cuff or strain. If the diagnosis is not readily apparent, your doctor might order an imaging test such as abdominal ultrasound, CT scan, or MRI. Examination of an adult for an inguinal hernia is best performed from the seated position with the patient standing. The inguinal canal, the areas for the bulge are visualized, a provocative cuff may be necessary to expose the hernia. The cuff is repeated as the examiner investigates the scrotum and feels for an impulse. Not all inguinal hernia need to be repaired, but all the hernia repairs require surgery. Small incisions that are not strangulated. Small hernias that are not strangulated, not blocking the blood supply to the intestine, and are not causing bowel obstruction or significant pain don't necessarily require surgery or emergency surgical repair. Now you can see all the findings are visible. These fluid collection, the gut loops in the inguinal canal, and you can focus by adjusting the depth, focus and gain of the ultrasound machine. You can find some important information in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. If you do like this video, please click the like button. Thanks.